Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the complete details regarding Andhra Pradesh Grama Sachivalayam jobs 2019. We are going to see the notification, online application, documents which are to be uploaded and salary, exam syllabus, examination dates, like the complete details in this video. So now let's begin the video. So coming to the notification, AP Grama Sachivalayam job notification has to be released on 15th July 2019, but it is postponed. So yesterday, that is on 20th of July 2019, it is officially announced that this online application begins from 23rd of July 2019. So, and the duration for the application is really less. You can get the online applications through the official website of ap.gov.in, and the application closes by 5th of August 2019. So you have less than 15 days. So and coming to the posts, 1,33,000 students, like, you know, there are 1,33,933 vacancies available for this job notification, and government told that 2 years there will be less salary. After 2 years, you are going to get the permanent jobs, irrelevant to the government. So though the government changes, the jobs are still permanent. So this is one of the greatest news, as there are 1,33,933 positions, job vacancies. Few lakhs of people will be applying to this particular job notification every day. So the server, the official server, that is ap.gov.in, will be always busy. So once the application is out, once the notification is out, apply as soon as possible. Now let's see what are the vacancies available for each and every job role, and what is the salary and age limit, and also educational criteria, like the complete details. Let's see. First, let's see what are the job post, like, you know, what are the roles open for this notification. So now let's see what are the job roles available for this notification. Coming to the job role notifications, the first job role is Panchayat Secretary, and next is VRO, and next is MPEO, and next is Gopalamitra. Gopalamitra is nothing but the veterinary doctor. And next role is Livestock Assistant, and then ANM, Electrical Assistant, and Gramina Engineer. So for Gramina Engineer, you should have BTech as your qualification. So coming to the next role, it is Welfare Assistant, and then Women Police Attendant, and then the Digital Assistant. Okay, so except for the Gramina Engineer, only for Gramina Engineer you should have BTech. You must have BTech as your educational qualification. For remaining, only degree is more than enough. You can be a degree holder in any of the good university, recognized university, and then you can happily apply, and you should have all your certificates with you, right from 10th to the current job requirement, that is from 10th to degree or 10th to BTech. If you are applying for Gramina Engineer, you must have your BTech certificate available readily. So now let's see how can you apply online. Okay, so once the application is out, what you need to do is you have to apply as soon as possible, because the server will be almost busy always, because this is the government job which is rarely announced, like this notification is rarely announced. So there is a lot of competition for this particular application and notification. So apply as soon as possible once the application is out. Now let's see what are the documents you need to keep ready before applying to this job notification. Okay, so first of all, you should have your 10th to degree certificates, all the certificates with you, and make sure you have e-copies, means just scan them and put them readily, okay, before applying, okay. And then you should have the certificate of your nativity, okay. Why they are asking you this particular certificate is for this AP Grama Sachivalayam notification. The government is giving 70% opportunities to the local people, that is Andhra Pradesh people, and 30% of the chances will be given, the 30% of the opportunities will be given to the non-locals. I'm repeating this point, 70% opportunities for local people and 30% for non-locals. So that's why you should even keep your certificate of residence or certificate of your nativity with you. Make sure you have e-copy of that as well. So, and then you should have all your educational qualification details, okay. Like they may ask you the transfer certificate, they may ask you the bona fide certificate. Just keep e-copies of all the educational certificates readily, okay. And then you should keep at least one of your identity card with you, okay. It's suggested to keep you Aadhaar card, like to keep your Aadhaar card with you, like the e-copy of Aadhaar card, keep readily. And the Aadhaar card should be connected to the phone number. Make sure you may keep everything ready before the notification is out. And then you should keep your date of birth, like, you know, the birth certificate is compulsory, and your date of birth in birth certificate should be as per your SSC certificate, okay. And then you should, if you have any other certificates, like, you know, if it is PHC category, then you have to keep your health certificate also with you. So these are the documents which you need to keep with you on or before applying for this job notification. And now let's see what are the other documents which are required for verification, okay. While verification, they will check all your like, you know, the certificates from 10th to degree or 10th to BTech. If you're applying for engineer post, like, you know, the Gramina engineer, then they are going to check your BTech certificate, else it is 10th to degree, okay. And then you should put all the certificates which I've already told you. They will check for verification, okay, for verifying, okay, later during your exam time, okay. Now let's see what are the different job roles and what are the different vacancies available, okay, for panchayat secretary. The job roles are, like, you know, the vacancies are 14,399 vacancies, okay. For Panchayat Secretariat, there are 14,399 vacancies, and coming to VRO, there are 10,580 vacancies, and coming to MPEO, there are 10,580 vacancies. And coming to the Gopalamitra and Livestock Assistant together, there are 10,500 plus vacancies. And coming to the Electrician Helper, there are 10,894 vacancies. Coming to the Gramin Engineer, the Village Engineer, there are 13,378 vacancies. And coming to the Women Police Assistant, there are 10,894 vacancies. Coming to the Digital Assistant, there are 10,580 vacancies, okay. Now let's see what are the few more details which I can tell you regarding this particular notification. Coming to the salary, starting 2 years, they are going to give you 15,015. So after 2 years, they're going to make your jobs permanent, and they are going to give you 30,000 salary directly, okay. So first 2 years you have to work for 15,015. After 2 years, they're going to pay you 30,000 directly, 30 to 35,000 directly, okay. And once you are done with your 2 years of duration, then all the facilities which they give you to which they give to permanent employees will be even applicable to you people, which is a good news, which is a great news. And after 2 years, your job will be permanent, irrespective to the government. Though the government changes, though the government is same, your jobs are still permanent. Okay, so this is the greatest news. And now let's see what are the other details which we can discuss regarding the syllabus. Okay, so coming to the syllabus and the paper pattern, now let's see what is the paper pattern. Coming to the selection process, you will be having two different rounds. First, there will be the written test, and second, there will be the interview round, direct interview. After direct interview, you can happily join in your job, in your training. So the training will begin from October 2nd approximately. So, and another thing is, there is no reservation. People need to prove based upon their talent. If you are having really a great talent, you can get the job. There is no reservation. There is 0% reservation for this job, which is a great thing. Now let's see what are the exam pattern for the written test. First, you need to write the written test. And once you qualify the written test, and once you cross the cutoff of your written test, then you can happily attend to the interview. Once you're done with your interview, once you're selected in your interview, then you can get the job. You can directly go to the training and get posted. Okay. Now coming to the exam pattern for written test, there will be two papers. Paper one consists of the general studies, general knowledge, general awareness, and all. And coming to the second paper, you will be having arithmetic logical ability. Okay, arithmetic aptitude as well as the logical ability. So coming to the paper one, general knowledge. Okay, you will be asked for 70 marks. Okay, the paper paper one, that is general knowledge, general awareness, you will be asked for 70 marks. And paper two, which contains of aptitude and logical ability, will be asked for 30 marks. In total, there are 100 marks. And now let's see what are the other few details. So the question paper will be consisting of two languages. The questions will be asked in English as well as in Telugu. And this is offline exam. You have to go to the examination center and then you have to attempt the exam. And the exam will be objective type, like the MCQs, multiple choice questions. So you need not worry. So there are no negative marking for this exam, which is a great news. There is no negative marking and there is no application fees. Okay. This exam is absolutely free. Okay. Once you apply, you need not pay any application fees. The application fees is completely zero. Okay. So now let's see what are the syllabus topics for the paper one, that is general knowledge. Coming to the general knowledge, you will be asked questions from current affairs. What are the different schemes which are launched by Andhra Pradesh government, and what is the Andhra Pradesh revenue system, and what are the different types of schemes which can, you know, like improve the village system, village administration. So the basic questions are going to be asked in exam. You need not panic, you need not be afraid, because there is no negative marking and the basic questions they'll ask. So just concentrate on current affairs, like the last 6 months current affairs and the schemes which are introduced by Andhra Pradesh government. Now coming to the paper two, you'll be asked arithmetic ability, that is arithmetic aptitude, and then they are going to ask you the questions from logical ability in the paper 2. So now let's see what is the syllabus for paper 2. Coming to the arithmetic ability, the portion, the syllabus is, the questions will be asked from interest, okay, the compound interest and the simple interest, and ratio and proportion, and profit and loss, averages, mensuration, percentages, like the basic chapters. Okay, So now let's see what is the portion, what is the syllabus for logical ability. Okay, coming to the logical ability, the syllabus is seating arrangement, data sufficiency, puzzle questions, coding decoding, syllogism, alphanumeric series, and blood relations, like the basic questions. Okay, so now let's see what are the other few more details which we can see. So coming to the suggestions which I would like to give you before applying, please make sure you have all your documents readily. Make sure you have all the e-copies of each and every documents which I've mentioned you. And second good news is that after 2 years they are going to make this job permanent. It is a greatest opportunity for all the students. If you have a degree certificate, you can happily apply for any of the job. And the third important tip is that follow the syllabus, please study well. There is very less time for your exam. There is approximately 1 month, not more than 1 month for your exam. So please prepare well, please concentrate on each and every important tip and each and every important topic which I've told you. Apply as soon as possible. Be confident, prepare well, practice well. I'll also make videos on preparation strategies and how you can prepare each and every topic which I've told you. So what you need to do is you have to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos. Don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends and also help them to get the job. So thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful. Subscribe, hit the bell icon, like and share, and all the very best. Apply as soon as possible and keep watching Best Way to Study.